Let's just kind of show you what we're going to do. So I need two international students who are born outside the U.S., who live outside the U.S. They're just here. Okay, so here's what I need. I need someone who's really into guns. Like an American who's really into guns, man. You have an NRA sticker? Okay, you're good. All right. Wait, hang on. Let me see that. Dude, not only that. Oh, shit. Look at this. Hey, can you get that? Put that on the screen. You got Trump. Dude, oh my God. Wait, hang on. Turn around. Show her shirt also. Shit. Okay. So, all right, come on the front. Emily is into guns.
Okay.
Like really into guns. And your job is to discover, because I know in Colombia, like basically no one has guns. I mean, not in Bogota, like it's impossible to get a gun in Colombia. Yeah. And in Australia, it's very difficult. So I want you to learn some things about guns in the United States by asking her questions.
I don't have good accuracy. Okay. Should I still go shooting? I really want to try it.
Oh, definitely, definitely. There's a bunch of like ranges that you can go to. I'm sure there's some in State College. I personally haven't gone shooting here, but yeah, there's people that can teach you. There's lessons. I personally would love to teach you if you want to learn.
And what what kind of attracts you to the guns? Is it like the feeling of the power, or is it just the action, or is it what attracts you to guns? What do you like?
Well,
about
it depends
guns?
On what kind of gun you're talking about. If you're talking about a rifle, like an AK-47 or an AR-15, it's something that they're just fun to shoot. Like they're fun to go to the range and have a beer and go shoot some skeet. But if it's like a pistol, that's more used for self-protection. I get to kind of practice in a situation where you'd need it.
Okay, let me coach you right here.
Right.
So, do you have a follow-up question?
What do you think about guns outside of the gun range?
I personally have a concealed carry permit. I don't carry on campus, so I'm not carrying right now. But I think it's a necessity, honestly. We just saw the thing that just happened down in Texas. And if it wasn't for the armed security guard there, there was probably a lot more lives would have been lost than the two men that were.
I'm like not against guns, but if everyone is allowed to have them, don't you think the shootings will go down in a way? Like if it's not that easy to get guns, wouldn't it be easier to control shootings or things like that? Since like you just mentioned Texas.
Yeah, so one, it depends on what kind of guns you're talking about. You can't just go out and buy an AK-47. Like you just can't do it. You have to have a background check and you have to have a permit for it. Concealed carry permits, it's a lot easier in Pennsylvania than other states to get it. So like I just lived in DC for a couple months, and there you have to take a class and you have to be trained to do it. So it's all kind of really depending on where you think about it politically. I personally think that you should be able to carry as a self-protection thing. That's not just from people either. I grew up on a farm where we had bears on our property that you can't really stop with a baseball bat.
You have bears on your property?
Yeah, have bears on my property growing up.
Okay, do you have another question?
I was going to say, do you like shooting more rangers or animals?
I do hunt,
What do you hunt for?
Deer. I do more archery than rifle, actually, for
You do
hunting.
Archery, too?
Yeah.
Could you, no kidding? Could you see that camera over there?
Yeah.
Could you hit that camera with a bow, with an arrow?
Probably.
Really?
Yeah.
Like the center of the camera or just the camera itself?
Probably. It's a couple.
The
ones.
Center?
Probably, depending on what sights you have on the bow and what
Damn.
Bow you have.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right.
Yeah.
Do you have another question for her?
So me being from Australia, we're not really used to seeing guns out in public. So when we went to Walmart, me and my friends, we were a bit like surprised just seeing it in a rack. And as we understand it, that it's just, you can't just buy it from the rack, but you need a permit and things like that. But don't you think the permit process is a bit liberal as well? Because if you have no prior offenses, I'm not too sure what the permit process is, but if you do not have a prior offense, do you think that is still too liberal to get a gun at the age of 18?
I don't, just because if you put certain regulations on certain things, so there's a thing called the red flag laws that people, that some Texas politicians like Dan Crenshaw are really going for, and it's a good in a sense that a red flag law means that you can't own a gun if like a psychiatrist or something says that you are not mentally fit for it,
yeah,
right?
Let's flag you.
But that can be abused. So I can say that I feel uncomfortable him having a gun around me because he smokes pot, and
no, I smoke
because
pot.
Because he smoked pot. Sorry, I assumed. Smoked pot, and I don't think he's mentally sound for that. So it can, and when he really could be, because it was a thing that he did in the past. You know what I mean? So it's something that could be abused. That.
Okay, so here's a question that y'all missed. That I will say, when she started talking, she said, well, it's not like, you know, sometimes it's different, every gun's different. Sometimes it's not like, you know, you go drink a beer and then you go shoot your AK-47. So, like, do you drink beer and shoot an AK-47? Have you ever done that?
Not an AK-47, but, like, 22s, yeah.
Okay,
like, rifles.
Okay,
so you shoot skeet on the range. All
right.
And it's all people around you. Like, there's people, the professionals there watching. It's not like you're getting drunk. It's like you're having one singular beer.
So what do you wish people, as a gun owner... And as a gun, you know, a gun enthusiast,
yeah.
What do you wish people would ask you when they, like, meet you? So they see your NRA sticker. What are some things you wish people would actually ask you?
Probably why, like, I feel strongly about having guns. Or not, like, having guns, but, like, being able to protect oneself instead of just assuming that, like... Like, I hate the assumption that people, when they think about, like, assault rifles, that anyone that owns an assault rifle wants to go out and kill somebody. I've had someone say that to me before, and I'm like, I do not. Like, I own assault rifles, and I'm not going to hurt anybody with it.
Yeah.
It's just for fun. It's for protection. It's for, you know.
Well, so here, this is actually kind of a really cool conversation, because it's like the stereotypes that we make of, like, all Muslims are, or... You know, poor people are this, or white people X, whatever it is, like Christians this. It's like all these things that we can say would be like people who own assault rifles are all like this kind of thing. So it's the same. It sort of goes around in lots of different ways.
So you say about protecting yourself. So protecting yourself against what? Animals, I understand. Like you said, you have bears on your property.
People, break-ins in your house.
Mm-hmm.
It happens all over the country. It happened in State College where an older gentleman at the Ramada, like last year, where the guy broke into his house after shooting up the bar and broke into his house. That's something that you could have something to protect yourself from. It's not necessarily going out and always having it on you, but having a rifle or having a pistol in your home to protect yourself from people or animals or, I'm a big Second Amendment person, government.